So, stupas means dome-like structure. In dome, any papers like rituals of the bodies, dead bodies. It is a dome-like structure. As you can see in the figure 1.2, dome-like structure where we are kept the dead body, like dead body of the Gautam Buddha or any famous person, whichever is considered by the people is very important. So they keep these body in the form of domes or stupa. And second thing is Biharas. Biharas is like prayer halls, okay? And Chaityas, it is a like we know about the hotels. For the pilgrimage, it is facilitated for the stay, means pilgrimage can stay here, can whatever they want to do, like preaching anything which is important for their survival, so they can do in these places, okay? Temple, you know, mosque, you know, tombs, as you know, Humayun tomb. So in tomb also dead body is kept in this place, like you know, even Taj Mahal, which is also types of dome. That means any dead body like Mumtaz Mahal dead body is kept in these places, okay? Places not in only in Taj Mahal. Fort, you know, like Red Fort, gates, India Gate, even historical places of our freedom movement like Sabarmati Ashram, Dandi, Bardoli, Vardha, Shantiniketan, Kolkata, Delhi, etc. It is a types of example. Can also be considered as a part of our cultural heritage. Why? Because if you want to read about the history, okay? So how can we trace and how can we know about the history? Because of these places, because of these stories, because of these books, we can trace our history, okay? As we know about Indus Valley Civilization, how can we know? Indus Valley Civilization nowhere mentioned, but by the digging process, by the mining process, we know about the Indus Valley Civilization, okay? Which is our first human civilization in Indian subcontinent, okay? Beside language, script, discovery of zero, mathematics, calendar, astronomy, iron, literature, religion, yuddha shastra, chariot, political science, zoology, botany, vastu shastra, religion, republic, judiciary, legislation, environment protection, etc. Besides these things, means which is above mentioned, all these also included, plus language. You know, India is a very diverse, every 4 kilometer you find new language. Even in Gujarati language you can see different dialects of the Gujarati. Saurashtra Gujarati is different, Mahisada Gujarati is different, even Surat Gujarati is different. Even if you considered UP, like Audhi is different, then many peoples belongs to Lucknow's Audhi difference. So Hindi is also differences in many part, like Braj Bhasa, etc. Okay. And second thing is script. Script, that means anything which is mentioned on the stone. As you can see in figure, stone, whichever is mentioned here, okay? Discovery of zero, as you know, India is discovered zero. Mathematics, yeah. Calendar, like you know, Bikram Samvat calendar and Gregorian calendar. And astronomy is about knowing the about the universe. Iron, literature like our Hindi, English, and any like language, like Tamil literature, Telugu literature, Kannada literature, etc. Religion, नो नीड टू एक्सप्लेन. युद्ध शास्त्र, चैरियट, पॉलिटिकल साइंस, जूलॉजी, बॉटनी, वस्तुशास्त्र एक्सेट्रा. ओके, इम्पॉर्टेंट डिस्कवरीज ऑफ इंडिया. द प्लेसेस कल्चरल लीजेंडरी, दैट मीन्स वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट, विच इज़ प्रोवाइडेड बाई द आवर फोर फादर. एंड आर्क्योलॉजिक इम्पॉर्टेंस आर लोथल, धोलका तालुका. लोथल वेयर मैंसन वेयर इज इस्टेब्लिश और वेयर इट इज, इट इज़ इन गुजरात इन धोलका तालुका. रंगपुर लिंबी तालुका इन सुरेंद्रनगर डिस्ट्रिक्ट. धोलावीरा कच्छ डिस्ट्रिक्ट. रोजड़ी और श्रीनाथगंज राजकोट डिस्ट्रिक्ट एक्सेट्रा. दीज प्लेसेस इज वेयर यू कैन फाइंड इन गुजरात इट्सेल्फ. ओके, द प्लेसेस ऑफ पिलग्रिमेज आर बिग ट्री, टॉवर ऑफ बंधानगर, स्टोन इंस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ किंग अशोका एट जूनागढ़, सन टेम्पल ऑफ मोधेरा, गेट ऑफ चंपारण, रुद्र महेला ऑफ सिद्धपुर, मानेसर लेक ऑफ विरामगम, जामा मस्जिद ऑफ अहमदाबाद, झूलता मीनारा, सेकिंग टावर्स, सिद्धि सियाद, दीन जली ग्रिल, टेम्पल्स ऑफ हाथी सिन्हा, सहस्त्रिंगलिंगा, लेक ऑफ पठान, राजमहल ऑफ बरोडा, टॉम ऑफ मोहब्बत. व्हाट इज दिस, दिस थिंग आर खान पारसी ग्यारे ऑफ नवसारी आर वर्थ सीइंग प्लेसेस. प्लेसेस हैविंग रिलीजन इम्पोर्टेंस आर द्वारकाधीश टेम्पल ऑफ द्वारका, सरदा पीठ ऑफ जगदगुरु शंकराचार्य, सोमनाथ टेम्पल वन ऑफ द 12 ज्योतिर्लिंगा फाउंड इन द गुजरात इट्सेल्फ, अंबाजी इन नॉर्थ गुजरात, बनसकंथा डिस्ट्रिक्ट एंड बहुचरजी, मनेसाना डिस्ट्रिक्ट, महसाना डिस्ट्रिक्ट, रनछोद्राई टेम्पल, धाकोर खेड़ा डिस्ट्रिक्ट एंड समनाजी अरावली डिस्ट्रिक्ट एक्सेट्रा. इट इज़ द ओनली एग्जाम्पल. सो हियर एनीथिंग विच इज प्लेस इन दिस बुक, इन दिस चैप्टर, इवन ऑन दिस स्पेसिफिकली इन पेज नंबर 4, ओनली यू नीड टू मग अप. सो हियर एनीथिंग इज नॉट फॉर द एक्सप्लेनेशन. सो वी जस्ट मूव टू द अनदर पेज नंबर इज 5. प्रिमिटिव मैन केम इन टू एग्जिस्टेंस इन ईस्टर्न साउथ अफ्रीका, ईस्टर्न साउथ अफ्रीका हियर. Sorry. Here, okay. Mesmerized by varied and prosperous heritage, many foreign tribes came to India. That means, any human kind, firstly they originated. We can say they found first place in the in Eastern South Africa. And after some period of time they moving around any continent like Asia, even North Africa, South America, North America, Europe, Siberia. So they are moving from here to many places. Okay, the Dravidians were considered to be best, to be the most ancient people of India. Dravidian means they belongs to mostly Plateau region of the India. Plateau region means southern part of the India. But the modern researcher of linguistic and anthropology have proved that even before the Dravidian, 6 more tribes come and settle in India. Let's explore more about them. First is Negritoid Hapsi people. As you know, Indian is considered as a Negro. Negro means their skin color is brownish color or something like grayish color. Okay, so some historians believe that the Negret or Negroes are the most ancient inhabitants of the India. Why? Because our territory is passing through the Tropic of Cancer. As you know, Tropic of Cancer is a very hot condition for the survival of the human kind. That's why temperature is high. If temperature is high, our skin for the survival, they become a dark in color, we can say. Okay. So they came from Africa via Baluchistan of India. Baluchistan today part of the Pakistan. They were black, having height of 4 to 5 feet and curly hair. Okay. Second is Australoid, Nisad people. Nisad, you first this tribe found in the your epic of Ramayana, like Nisad. As you know, boatman, they carry Rama and Lakshman, Sita with their boat. As you know about Nisad, people of this tribe come from Southeast Asia. Southeast Asia means India here. India is also present in South. So South, East here and this region. Okay. Their physical features are black skin with broad head. Broad head means anything which is in this situation. Okay. Broad, like horizontally, is very fitted. Flat nose, short in height, etc. The Aryan who came later into India call them Nisad. So who pronounced this name Nisad? Like Aryans came into India from the Siberian. It is a disputed where they come from, but most of the historians agree on the Siberian. That's why I say Siberia. So they called Indian people as a Nisad. The origin of the tribes like Kol, Munda, Khasi tribes of Assam, the tribes of Nicobar and Myanmar have similarities to the Australoids. Australoid, mainly they survive in southern part. Their contribution in the development of Indian culture and civilization is immense. As you know, people, whenever people they live, they come together, form society, then they set up norms, rule, regulation for the society, how they develop, how their education system should be, how their cultural system should be, everything. So for, because culture is not a only one day process, culture is a historical process, long day process. Okay. This made clay, they made clay utensils, wore cotton cloth and knew many other skills. They had great religious belief too. As you know, many peoples belongs to tribal category, but they believe in the god in the form of tree, in the form of river, in the form of sun, moon, etc. Okay. Third thing is Dravidian. Dravidian are considered to be creator of Sindhu Valley civilization. Sindhu Valley civilization of Mohenjo-daro and the direct descendant of stone are culture. That means they belongs to Indus Valley civilization. Considered, it is because we not have, even today have not any types of clarity in this history. Is even especially for the ancient history, we not have very much types of concluded ideas or very findable ideas. Okay. The tribe which come from north survived with their language and cultural feature. Later on they are only called as Dravidian. First they come from where? North. Survived with their language and cultural feature, and later on they are only called as Dravidian. Dravidian gave the concept of mother as a goddess. Imagine they are how much developed in the form of society, because they considered mother as a goddess and father as a god. So they thought of Parvati and Shiva as a mother and father developed, because you know our Parvati and Shiva is a like primary human means they survive in a forest area. Our Shivji is not belongs to any temple. Today Shivji is only in the form of shivling. You cannot see in a mainly part of the statue. So because of this reason, they considered they belongs to ourselves. That's why they considered Shivji as a father and Parvati Ma as a mother. Okay. Moreover, the tradition of worshipping nature is the gift of the Dravidian. So, worshipping prayer, they mostly come from the as a cultural from the Dravidian. Tradition of worshipping with dhoop. You know dhoop. Incense stick like agarbatti, as you can say, deep lamp, aarti are considered to be gift of Dravidians. Besides nature and animal worship, etc. That means they are so worshipping the nature like sun, moon, etc. Worshipping are the great feature. Originally, deities of the Dravidians have been accepted by Aryans. Dravidians deities also accepted by whom? Aryans. And were re-established by them god of a culture with pace of time. So gradually these types of belief considered as a form of religion, then religion is now considered as a in form of temples. So religion is a very broad term considered than the only one temple or any mosque or any church, etc. Okay. Under the tremendous influence of North Aryan culture was deeply internalized by the Dravidian. Aryan culture was deeply internalized by the, so Dravidian culture and Aryan culture, they are interlinked. Hence, inter-caste marriage took place. In this time, we see inter-caste marriage, like you know, Rama and Sita belongs to different types of caste, but they marry. But in today's our culture is not culture, we cannot say, because culture is have given evidence of the intercaste marriage, but even today's our society is not allow their children to marry with another caste. So it is a types of stigma, it is a type of taboo. Even it is a very favorable condition for the, if you are married within family, they mostly probably for the very verge for the disease. So we need to marry in different caste, different religion, they are promotable. But today's our culture, not today's our society is not accepting these things. Dravidian and matriarchal system of family. Dravidian progress a lot of different craft art like building a boat, raft, weaving, spinning. It is an example only, so here no need to explain. Due to the dominance of the Aryan, they shifted to South India and settled there. As you know, anywhere if people not found any types of respect because their color is compared to Aryan have dim. That's why they are not respectable by the Aryans. So they moving toward the South India. First they are come from the North India, but over a period of time they move South India. As a result of today, we can see the people speaking Dravidian family language like Tamil, Telugu, Kannada and Malayalam, etc. So today's discussion is completed, and in next topic we try to cover your whole chapter. Okay, so keep learning, keep safe, goodbye, see you.